Hello dear students, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the electrostatics only, electric field. In that, we are going to discuss about the electric field. See, how can we define this electric field? Now, definitions are not required for you for MCQs. Then also, I am just telling about the electric field. Electric field means the region around a charge where the effect of that charge is there. That is positive and positive charge. If a charge, see, a positive charge is here and another positive charge is, I'm keeping it at this distance. There is no repulsion between these two charges. Then the second charge is not coming under the electric field of the first one. So where the region around the charge where it is getting an attraction or repulsion with the other charge, that is called electric field. Okay, then this concept of electric field was introduced by the scientist Faraday. Faraday had given the concept, the what is that, electric field. So in here we will be considering a source charge which is producing electric field, that is the source charge, and the Q2, which I am taking it next to Q1, source charge is considered as the test charge. Okay, so next we are going to consider about electric field intensity. What is meant by electric field intensity? Electric field intensity we can find out with the formula E equals F by Q0. Okay, force by Q0. So this is the formula for electric field intensity, and its unit is Newton per Coulomb. Force is Newton divided by Coulomb, Newton per Coulomb. It's a vector quantity. That also you keep in mind. It's a vector quantity. Next, yes, we are going to consider about electric field due to a point charge. So if I am considering a point charge Q, what will be the electric field? So we know that electric field, as distance increases, what will happen to the effect of electric field will be decreasing. How it is decreasing? It is inversely proportional to R square, that is E equals 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by R square. So this is the formula for finding out the electric field, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R square. Q1 and Q2 are two charges, then force is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 divided by R square as per Coulomb's law. But now we are going to we are considering about the electric field divided by test charge. So only one charge will be here, coming here, 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R square. So instead of this one charge, if there are n number of charges, how will we find out the electric field? Electric field we can find it out with the help of, well, sum of all the charges. See here, first I'll consider two charges, okay, X, Y, Z. See, there's three axes. I'm considering a charge, a plus Q here, and another charge I'm considering over here, and this is the origin O. From here, this is at a distance R1 and this is at a distance R2. I need to find out the electric field at the point P. Electric field at the point P from, see, from first charge A, from the point which is given over here, that is Q1, instead of plus Q, I'm giving it as Q1 here. Here B, I'm giving it Q2. So how will I find out the electric field? Electric field here, I can find out the distance between these two charges. Suppose if it is R0, this will be R2 minus R0, and this will be R1 minus R0. So electric field will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. See, Q1 divided by R1 minus R2 minus R0 the whole square plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q2 divided by R1 minus R0 the whole square. Okay, so we should take sum of the electric field due to each charge at a particular point. Okay, what will be the total electric field? This is how we will, if we have a group of charges, the same way we will be finding out the total electric field. So instead of that, n number of charges are there, we can use the sigma symbol. See, E due to n number of charges, sigma I equals 1 to n, 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 is a constant. So if you want, you can take it outside also. Qi divided by R0 minus Ri the whole square. okay, into this will be the electric field due to the group of charges. If I am considering a group of charges, total electric field will be like this. And here E equals F by Q0. That formula also you need to remember. Next is electric field lines means it's a curved one or it can be a straight line in which the it will be always. See, electric field is moving in this direction. This is the tangent to which will be giving us the direction of electric field. Electric field lines is a path. It's a straight or curved path in an electric field, which will be giving the direction of electric field intensity. Electric field intensity we can find out with the help from the electric field lines. It can be a curved one or it can be a straight one. Plus positive charge, it is moving outside. From positive, it will be moving outside direction and it will be straight line like this. And negative charge, this means it will be moving towards this one. Okay, and one positive and one negative charges are there means it will be one positive and one negative charges are there means it will be moving from positive to negative. So what will be the direction of electric field intensity? Along the tangent it will be acting. Okay, if it is uniform electric field lines means we will be representing it with the parallel lines. This is about the uniform electric field. Okay, next we are going to what are the properties of electric field lines? Electric field lines are, see, it is it won't be forming closed loops. Okay, electric field lines won't form closed loop, they are continuous lines. First property is they are continuous, they are not forming closed loops. Okay, then the tangent will give the direction of electric field intensity. Then they won't intersect each other. If they are intersecting each other, it is giving more than one direction. So, it won't intersect each other. Electric field lines are always normal to the surface of conductor. Normal to the surface of a conductor. While we are considering a conductor, electric field lines will be always normal to the surface. Okay. So, these are the important properties of electric field lines. Okay, clear? So next we are going to consider about how can we find out the electric dipole. In electric dipole, one of the charge into this distance between the two charges. Okay, two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance. So this is called an electric dipole. Well, dipole moment we can find out with the formula Q into 2A. One of the charges into the distance between the two charges. So that is electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment gives the strength of electric dipole. Okay, it's a vector quantity. Its direction is from negative to positive charge. Electric dipole moment direction is from negative to positive charge. Next is electric field. What is the unit of electric field lines? Electric field lines unit is electric dipole. Unit of electric dipole is coulomb meter. Coulomb meter. Direction is from negative to positive charge. Okay. Next we found out the electric field in due to a dipole if we are considering a point on the axial line or equatorial line. So axial line, if I am considering a point on the same axial line, if I am considering the electric field intensity of a dipole, if I am considering a point on the axial line, it will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 2 pr divided by r square minus a square the whole power whole square. This is the formula. So in short form, when I am representing, we can represent it as 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 2 p by r cube, because r is very much greater than a when we are considering. So r to the power 4 and 1 r will get cancelled. We will be getting it as 2 p divided by r cube. This is for the axial line. But when we are considering the equatorial line, that is perpendicular line, when I am considering, electric field will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 p by r cube. This it won't be this in axial line, it is 2 p by r cube, and here it is equatorial line, it is p by r cube. So what will be the relation connecting e equatorial and e axial? See, e axial line will be twice of e equatorial line. right? This is the electric field. What is the relation? So here you need to understand that electric field due to a single charge, when I am considering a single charge plus Q charge only, electric field how we got E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R square for a single charge. But for a dipole, we got it as E is proportional to 1 by R cube. Okay, E is proportional to 1 by R cube in the case of a dipole. But if we are considering an electric point charge, E is proportional to 1 by R square. So next we are going to consider electric dipole in a uniform two-dimensional electric field. If I am considering in a two-dimensional electric field, when I am considering an electric dipole, what will happen? There will be a rotational effect, torque acting on the system. You are remembering, right? It is in a two-dimensional, if it is making an angle theta with respect to the electric field, then torque acting on the system will be equal to P cross E. Torque is a vector quantity, tau equals P cross E. Here an important point also there, stable equilibrium and unstable equilibrium. P cross E means PE sine theta, right? So the torque tries to align the electric dipole in the direction of field. So here when P is along the direction of E, what will be the angle between them? Theta will be equal to 0. So what will be torque? Torque is equal to 0. There is no rotation. That means it is in stable equilibrium. So when we will be getting stable equilibrium? When theta, P and E are along the same direction. There is no torque. That's what we told now. See, electric field and the dipole are in the same direction. But electric field and the dipole, both are making an angle theta. This is what we considered and we got an equation P cross E. Tau equals P cross E. If P is along the direction of E, we are getting a stable equilibrium. But if P is perpendicular to this E, what will happen? Then we are getting theta as 90. Maximum torque will be getting PE. This is called an unstable equilibrium. Such cases, the dipole will be in unstable equilibrium. That is when theta equals 90 degree. Okay, torque formula, you know, this unit, you know, Newton meter. This is the form unit for torque. Okay, clear? So torque acting on the system on a dipole, that is PE. So when the dipole is in a uniform electric field, what will happen? If the dipole is in a uniform electric field, I am considering the dipole like this. It is this here I am considering minus Q and here it is plus Q, and electric field is acting in this direction and dipole moment is acting from negative to positive charge. So what will happen to the net torque acting on the system? Net torque acting on the system will be equal to zero, and net force also will be equal to QE minus QE, right? So total force is equal to zero, total torque acting on the system will be equal to zero because here it is in a uniform electric field. Next, we are considering a non-uniform electric field. Okay, and this electric field is non-uniform, which is increasing in the direction of dipole. Electric dipole is increasing in the direction, electric field is increasing in the direction of dipole. Okay, now in those cases, we can consider theta as equal to P and E are in the same direction, right? So theta will be equal to zero. So we will be getting P is along the direction of electric field. Okay, so if field is decreasing along the direction of P, what will happen? Net force on the dipole is, what will, so forgot to tell you about the net force. Net force in which direction it will be acting? It will be acting in the direction of E. Okay, net force will be acting in the direction of E itself. But in the, if we are considering a field in the decreasing along the direction of P, instead of increasing along the direction of P, if I am considering decreasing along the direction of P, what will happen? Net dipole will be, net force will be opposite to the direction of P, and net torque acting on the system will be equal to zero at that time also. Clear? So next we are going to consider about the potential energy of a dipole in a uniform electric field. Potential energy. Potential energy equals minus P dot E. These formulas and all you need to by heart. Okay, minus P dot E. Usually this one, the total formula we need to take, this is under the condition potential energy. How can, what is the formula for potential energy? First I'll start from the initial formula itself. It is potential energy equals minus PE into cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. Okay, so when it is under acting of torque is acting from theta 1 to theta 2, then the total potential energy is minus PE into cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. Okay, so if it is rotating an angle theta, that is initially it is the theta is equal to 0 and then it is making an angle theta, then what will be U? U will be equal to minus PE cos theta minus P dot E we will be getting. Cos theta minus 1. Cos 0 is 1, so minus PE cos theta minus 1. Okay, minus PE cos theta minus 1. Cos theta minus 1. This is about the potential energy. So, if the torque is applying the on a dipole, if the dipole is rotating or orienting at an angle from theta 1 to theta 2, then the potential energy is minus PE into cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. If it is rotating an angle theta from which is aligned in the same direction and after that it is rotating an angle theta, then potential energy will be equal to minus PE cos theta minus 1. Okay, so here next, if it is rotating an angle from 90 degree to, see initially I am considering theta 1 as 90 degree and it is making an angle, it is going to an angle 0. Then what will be the potential energy? Minus PE into cos theta, cos 0 is 1, cos 90 is 0. So we will be getting minus PE, we will be getting. Okay, so it depending on whatever be the angle, according to that you can change this. So anyway, potential energy you write it as minus P dot PE into cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. Okay, clear children? So today's topic, today this is the and energy. Energy, what is the unit of energy? That is joule. Okay, so I hope today's video is useful for you, and in next class I'll be doing some of the MCQs relating to this. I hope it is clear for you, and if you have any suggestions please tell that through the comment box. Thank you for watching. Bye.